Welcome to another episode of the Carolina Bay of the Day. Today I can tell you that yes, there are Carolina Bays in Texas. In a recent video, I asked the viewers to help me find Carolina Bays in Texas. My request was motivated by a review of a paper published by Richard Firestone in 2009 that showed an elliptical bay with raised rims in Texas. Figure 3 in Firestone's 2009 paper shows an image of a Carolina Bay in Texas and four lines directed toward the Great Lakes. The endpoints of the lines are in the Texas Panhandle and in the central western part of Texas. Not long after my video was published, I got an email from Chris Cottrell from the Dabbler's Den that said, "Hey Tony, glad to see the pacemaker is doing his job. I have a few Texas bays marked on my map that appear to have raised rims. Not sure if they are the ones mentioned by Firestone, but they are worth taking a look at." Chris included geographical coordinates for an area in the north central part of Texas close to the border with Oklahoma. My previous search for the Carolina Bay mentioned by Firestone had been guided by the endpoints of the lines that he had drawn from Texas toward the Great Lakes. The locations in West Texas did not have any Carolina Bays, and the location in the Panhandle had a terrain with indentations that did not have elliptical geometry or the raised rims typical of Carolina Bays. The features in the Panhandle shown in this image looked like karst depressions, and due to their mostly circular shape, it was impossible to say with certainty that their alignment converged by the Great Lakes as shown in Firestone's image. The Carolina Bays have several distinguishing characteristics because they were formed by secondary impacts of glacier ice pieces ejected by one or more extraterrestrial impacts on the Laurentide ice sheet. We have to keep these characteristics in mind when trying to evaluate if a geologic feature is a Carolina Bay. The Carolina Bays are elliptical because they originated as inclined conical cavities that became shallow elliptical depressions by viscous relaxation. The raised rims are characteristic of impact cratering. The stratigraphically raised rims are produced by compressive horizontal forces during the penetration of the projectile into the target and by debris ejected ballistically around the cavity. The raised rims are formed from the overturned flaps of the penetration funnels. The Carolina Bays occur only on unconsolidated ground that was liquefied by the seismic vibrations of the ice boulder impacts. Saturated ground can be liquefied by seismic vibrations of magnitude 6 or higher. Ice projectiles are able to penetrate liquefied ground without fragmenting. The bays are oriented toward the Great Lakes, which is the location from where the ice boulders were ejected by one or more extraterrestrial impacts on the Laurentide ice sheet. The Carolina Bays are generally located within 1,500 kilometers from the Great Lakes, which is the approximate range of the ballistic trajectories. The Carolina Bays have a wide range of sizes and they frequently overlap each other while maintaining their elliptical shape. This is the area reported by Chris Cottrell. We can see several features that are eroded, but they appear to be elliptical with raised rims. I will focus my attention on the feature pointed by the arrow, which is less than half the size of the Carolina Bay in Firestone's figure. The feature is 454 meters above sea level, and it has raised rims on its northeast and southern margins. The rim is broken in the east by a drainage channel. The western part of the feature is a straight line running from north to south because it is the boundary of a rectangular farm field. A satellite image of the same area indicates that the feature is called Raid Lake in Haskell County, Texas. It is adjacent to Highway 277. The rectangular field to the west of the lake can be seen clearly. It is easy to make mistakes when measuring an irregular feature like this one. More reliable results can be obtained by plotting the points along the perimeter of the feature and then fitting an ellipse using the least squares method. In this particular case, I plotted 23 points along the regular margin on the north and on the southeast of the feature, following the topographic level indicated by the yellow color adjacent to the green color. I avoided the distortion from the drainage area on the east and the straight section of the rectangular farm field on the west. The ellipse corresponding to the plotted points has a major axis of 1,108 meters and a minor axis of 780 meters. This ellipse has a heading of 225 degrees. Overlaying the ellipse on the feature, we can see that one of the points near the break of the rim on the east side is outside the ellipse. This demonstrates the benefit of using multiple points as the basis for measuring Carolina Bays that are degraded by erosion and human activity. The points that follow the contour of the raised rim fit the ellipse well. We can feel confident that this was an elliptical structure before the rim was breached for drainage and before the incursion of the rectangular farm field on the west. The heading of the ellipse is approximately 225 degrees. Extending the heading of 225 degrees toward the Great Lakes as a great circle trajectory, we can see that the Texas Basin is oriented toward Lake Michigan at a distance of 1,573 kilometers. This is close enough to the range of 1,500 kilometers indicated by the concentric circles from Saginaw Bay, which is the epicenter of the extraterrestrial impact proposed by Michael Davias. We can conclude that Reed Lake in Texas is a Carolina Bay because it has the essential characteristics of the impact basins. The Great Circle paths forming the extensions of the major axes of the impact basins that I have reviewed before intersect at various points on the map. The lines from Nebraska, North Carolina, and Virginia intersect near Lake Michigan. The lines from Kansas, Oklahoma, Georgia, and South Carolina intersect closer to Saginaw Bay. The new trajectory for the Reed Lake in Texas, indicated by the arrow, intersects at Lake Michigan. The evidence for multiple extraterrestrial impacts in the Great Lakes region continues to accumulate. The hypothesis that fragments of a disintegrated comet struck the Earth 12,900 years ago gains support with each rigorous analysis of the Carolina Bays. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. I will continue to examine the Carolina Bays one bay at a time. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays.